A couple of fans sent me a Newcastle United shirt. I've got no hair, do you remember? Yeah. The photo last week. Apparently there was some comment made about us being looking a little bit like a football hooligan. Well, I'm not actually a football hooligan.
Hang on, were you a Sunderland fan?
This is right. This is the reason I'm phoning up. Basically, I'm part of a group called We Are United. I actually run the Newcastle United fanzine, the number 9. And we've amalgamated in a campaign to overturn the ban on away fans in Newcastle United and Sunderland games next season. We feel the decision is ludicrous, and we still haven't actually found out. The police and the clubs are both passing the buck between each other, and Newcastle United fans and Sunderland fans are just incensed at the fact that we're deprived from going to each other's games. Sunderland have said that it's a safety issue. Why are Middlesbrough fans allowed to go to Sunderland and St James's Park when that is also a local derby?
This is it, because we gave it quite a lot of coverage and asked all our guests, and nobody can really see any reason why Newcastle and Sunderland shouldn't be allowed to meet at the local derbies. Mickey, let's get your point of view.
No, I mean, aware of the fierce rivalry between the two clubs, but I think over the years there's never been a great deal of trouble involved at either ground. So, pinpoint a reason why the ban has been enforced, or lift it.
Yeah, what can happen now? Steve, what can happen? Because you say the club and the police are passing the buck between...
That's right. When we've had contact with the Premier League, we've had contact with independent supporters associations involved with Liverpool, Everton and Manchester United. Liverpool and Everton fans are also worried because their allocation have also been reduced. And we're just afraid that it could be a part of a grandiose plan, maybe by the FA, possibly even at a higher level. Liverpool and Sunderland have both come out and said... they're trying to ease us off by saying you can come and watch it at St James's Park and Roger Park on a giant TV screen, you know, the two away games. But I mean, we've also had contact with some of the players, and obviously I went down to training Wednesday, and the players aren't happy about it, because obviously a couple of the players have said when we score a goal at Roger Park, it's not going to be much fun having nobody to cheer in front of us, to cheer us on. But it's good to see that Newcastle United and Sunderland supporters have actually, the press, the media are making us out to be the ultimate rivals. It really is hate, but I mean it's not like that. Newcastle United and Sunderland fans can unite. We're actually going to be in Sunderland City Centre with the petition. We were in Newcastle City Centre last week. We got over 4,000 signatures. And the campaign's going on down to Wembley at the Charity Shield. We've got Manchester United supporters helping. They're hoping to overturn this decision. It's really for the good of all football fans, not just Newcastle United and Sunderland fans.
Right, where are you going to take that petition to?
It's at the Bridges Shopping Centre in Sunderland. We're going to present it to the police and the clubs. We're hoping to have a meeting in the next couple of weeks between the police and the clubs. That's if we can, persuade them to come around the table. They don't seem to be too interested.
You must fear, Steve, that you're not actually going to be able to resolve this, and that, well, at least for a year, you're not going to be able to go to the away match.
This is it. I mean, it is ludicrous. I mean, obviously, my idea. I mean, the last thing I would want to do is to, just to sit back and let the police and the football clubs get away with this. I mean, it is ludicrous to say that you can't control 1,000 people. The other 1,000 people who travel to Roga and travel to St James's Park are actually season ticket holders, even possibly bond holders and platinum club holders. And it means that they're all on the computer at the club causing trouble at these matches, then your ticket will be taken off you. And I mean, that's a big enough threat as it is, without trying to say, cutting away from that, last season offered 6,000 tickets for the Arsenal game. Now, a person who I'll not name for libelous reasons actually managed to knock our allocation down to 1,500 because he doesn't agree with Newcastle United supporters travelling to a win. That to my mind is ridiculous. I mean, if you've got somebody at your own club saying that Newcastle United fans are going to go away and cause trouble, then I think you're right, we probably will be fighting a loop. At the end of the day, we want to go to Sunderland, the Sunderland fans want to come to St James's, and I mean, I hope you agree with that. I mean, Mickey as well, I mean, being away as he says, I mean, it is, we want as much, support from people up and down the country as possible, and we need a lot of national attention, because at the moment it's only local attention and media attention we're getting. And because if it happens in Newcastle and Sunderland, what's to say it's not going to happen elsewhere in the country?
But for the game itself, I mean, the beauty of derby games is the atmosphere, and if you've only got one set of supporters there, then it's never going to generate the atmosphere of having both sets.
And just defeats the whole object.
Yeah, that's right. I mean, what's the point of having a derby game against two locals? There'll be any atmosphere.
I wonder what would happen if they stopped it in Celtic Rangers matches.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the beauty.